What's up, everybody? Back with a week 3 review. It's a bit late, but that doesn't matter. Let's just get right into it. With the first game of the week, we had the 49ers versus Giants on Thursday Night Football. I mean, honestly, who know, everyone thought that the 49ers were gonna win. I don't think there was anyone that thought the Giants were actually gonna win. There's no one that I thought actually thought that. Oh, you know, what if the Giants actually upset the? No. No one's thinking that. And if you're thinking that, then you're just delusional. Because the 49ers were better in every way, and they showed that with a 30-0 victory. I mean, I'm not surprised. Honestly, I would have been. I thought they were gonna win by a lot more. That's only real thing that I'm really surprised about. But the Giants just cannot stop. They couldn't stop McCaffrey, and they couldn't stop Debo. It was insane. And get better, Giants. Because, like, what are y'all doing? It's like, I don't get it. Shoot, man. It was kind of bad for y'all. Okay. It wasn't the worst loss of the week. Let's just say that. Y'all got something to look forward to. Because it wasn't the worst loss of the week. We'll get to that later on. But next, we got the Lions and the Falcons. Honestly, thought this was going to be a lot closer of a game. But the Lions, 120-6, I wasn't really. Didn't turn out the way I expected. I thought this was going to be like a lot of high scoring games. So, to be honest, I was. I'm a bit. Upset is an understatement, because like I'm thinking, oh, this is gonna be a great game. Got two great offenses. You got two pretty good offenses. Got a lot of weapons. This is gonna be a high scoring game, and only be 20-6. I expected more from the Falcons. Yeah, it was just kind of a meh game. But hey, Lions, y'all, like, I think y'all are 2-1 now. I think, yeah, they're 2-1. Well, 3-1 now, technically, at the time of this recording. But hey, they're 3-1. But back then, they were 2-1. But look, I got high hopes for the Lions. I really think they're gonna make a playoff push this year, and I can't wait to see what they're gonna do for the rest of the year. Next, we have the Chargers and the Vikings. Let's just say this: the Vikings and the Chargers. They're the exact same team, and I can't be the only one that has realized that these two are quite literally the same team, but just in AFC and NFC version of each other. So I knew this was gonna be a great game, and it's 28-24, so I'm not mad at it. One of the more highlight plays of it was the Keenan Allen pass. Really, that kind of shocked me, to be honest with you. That kind of shocked me, but also Keenan Allen had 215 yards while Justin Jefferson had 149 yards. I mean, like, I was surprised that these two have really high numbers. I mean, like, everyone knew that was going to happen, so can't really say that we're really surprised. And then Justin Herbert had 405 yards, 3 TDs, while Kirk Cousins had 367, 3 TDs, and 1 INT. So, yeah, I don't really know what else to say, but great game for both teams. I really, honestly, it could have gone either way. It really could have gone either way. I really thought that I was not going to be surprised if this went into overtime somehow. I don't know how it was going to go into overtime, but I wouldn't be surprised. Next game, we have the Packers and the Saints. Saints, how do y'all manage to mess this up? How do y'all manage? Y'all were up 17-0 in the fourth quarter, and then not only do you allow the Packers to come back, but you also lose the. You missed a field goal, and they went because y'all missed a field goal. Like, great game from the Saints. But when Derek Carr went down with that shoulder injury, it just went downhill for y'all. And I'm just like, oh, wow, that's, I can't believe it. Because, like, when Jameis came in, I'm like, oh, they still have a chance. But obviously not, because y'all couldn't steal the game. Jameis got y'all into field goal range. Jameis Winston had the game won for y'all, and all you had to do was hit the make the field goal. You couldn't even do that. Be ashamed of yourselves. Be absolutely ashamed of yourselves. Terrible. Just terrible. I can't believe it. Like, I'm disappointed. It's just, how do you let that happen? The Saints will look amazing the whole game. I will say that. The Saints looked amazing the whole game, except in that fourth quarter, because they absolutely sold. But hey, good job for the Packers for coming back. Y'all show resiliency. Y'all stayed in it basically the whole game, and the Saints just absolutely collapsed, and y'all capitalized on it. So good for y'all. So next game we have the Texans and the Jaguars. Jaguars, I gotta say this. Y'all, what is going on with it? What is going on with the Jaguars? What's going on with the Jaguars? I don't get it. I thought this is gonna be another playoff contender team in the AFC, but in the first 4 weeks, I'm just not seeing it. Like, I don't get it. I don't get what's going on with the Jags. I know they won in London. Like I said, this is gonna come out while info games are happening. So these are gonna be a bit out of date. But like, the Jags, I'm not seeing what I saw last year. And I'm disappointed. Cause I wanna see a really good, I was hoping to see another playoff team again. And I can't see it. I'm not seeing it right now. And I'm disappointed. I'm disappointed in you and the Jaguars and the team. Just everything. I'm disappointed. Texans, great job. Y'all looked amazing. CJ Stroud has looked amazing. The whole team has looked awesome. I can't wait to see what this team has. Once this team gets better, I definitely see that they're going to be a playoff team in the near future. Not right now. Like, they might win like seven or eight games, but like, they're definitely going to be a playoff team. And I'm really happy to see how they can develop, and I'm really excited for the Texans, because I feel like they found their franchise quarterback, and let's hope that he doesn't get caught for any kind of sort of misconduct. Knock on wood, you know what I mean? Well, knock on wood. Hopefully, he doesn't end up like Deshaun Watson. But hey, hopefully the Texans have found their franchise quarterback, and it'd be amazing for them, because they struggled for so long. Not really for so long. At the time, Watson, they didn't really struggle. But, like, they've been notoriously a bad team. So I would love to see them actually be really good again. And then Broncos, Dolphins. 10 touchdowns. Over, like, 350 yards passing. 350 yards rushing. It was a disaster. Like, Broncos, what happened? Like, no, like, seriously. Like, I mean, like, seriously, Broncos, what happened? What happened? How does this happen? How? Like, I don't even know what to say. I don't even know what to say. Cause like, how does this happen? How? Why? Why? What is that? Why? Why did y'all do? Like, I knew y'all were gonna get beat, but yo, that bad though. Yo, Mike McDaniels could he, not Mike McDaniels. The Dolphins head coach name is, he could easily dropped 73 on y'all and said, nah, I'ma show mercy. Like, look, I can't say I would do the same if I was him, But like, how do y'all get cooked that bad though? Like, jeez. Dolphins. Not Dolphins, but the Broncos. Y'all got Sean Payton as your quarterback. And then y'all lose that badly. I can't believe y'all. Just terrible game all around for the Broncos, not the Dolphins. Dolphins, great game. It was too easy for them. It was like they really looked at the Broncos like, you know what? I feel like giving you the butt whooping of a lifetime. How does that sound? And the Broncos just like, sure. They just bent over and just like accepted it. Like they quite literally bent over and then accepted that they were gonna get got. Like, how do you? I don't know. I'm disappointed. Yeah, Browns and Titans. Browns, not surprised that they won. Honestly, that running back, I forgot his name. He had a really good game. I think what was his name? What's the dude's name? What's the running back's name? Was it last week? I don't know. But honestly, Titans disappointed. I don't know I'm maybe beating myself because I don't know what to say about these games. Like, this is just like a game of like blowouts, really. This was like a bunch of blowouts this week. So there was not much to really say about steady games. So yeah, Bills, Commanders. Bills, I'm not surprised that they won. Commanders, terrible game. Sam Howell threw a couple of picks. Just couldn't get nothing going. He threw a pick, and he went right into the defender's hands. And he returned it for a touchdown. I'm like, yo, how do you even... I don't know. I don't know what to say anymore. Because, I don't know what to say. Good game, Bills. Really, that's all I gotta say. Colts, Ravens. Ravens, y'all should have beat them. Ravens, that's all I gotta say. Like, how do you lose to the Colts? Like, I know, like, we should have gotten a couple of calls. Like, yeah, I get it. Sure. Like, oh, we should have gotten, you should have done the calls that, but like, at the end of the day, it's the Colts. Y'all should beat the Colts. Y'all lost to Gardner. I think Gardner Minshew was in the game, right? I'm pretty sure Gardner Minshew was in the game. Y'all lost to Gardner Minshew. Like, how does that happen? I have no clue. But like, Ravens, I'm disappointed. Again, I'm disappointed. Y'all should have easily won that. But hey, Colts, good job. Y'all hung in there with Gardner Minshew, even though Anthony Richardson went down. Y'all end up getting the win. Good for y'all. I don't care if the Ravens will complain, like, oh, we should have gotten these calls, blah, blah, blah. Like, at the end of the day, y'all lost. It's not going to do much. And I know I may sound weird saying that as an NFL fan, because like, there's going to be a couple of times where it's like, oh, well, if we didn't get this, if we got this call, yada, yada. I'm like, yeah. There are times. But hey, anyways, Patriots and Jets. 15-10. I don't know what to say. I didn't really watch this game. I couldn't really care about the game, honestly. It's the Jets and the Patriots. Like, I don't know. I don't, what do you want me to say about this game? It's all right, I guess. Moving on. Seahawks and the Panthers. Seahawks, great game. Y'all look good. Panthers look good, even though Bryce Young went out and Andy Dalton took his spot. Andy Dalton, not gonna lie, looked pretty good that game. I'm pretty impressed with him. We all knew Andy Dalton was good. Let's be honest. He's always been a good player, but he just got older, and yeah. But good for y'all. Andy Dalton did look good, so hopefully he can play good for y'all as long as Bryce Young is gonna be out, so he can. It's like it's a veteran presence, so he can keep y'all afloat too. You know, instead of running offense, y'all are gonna be just fine, I think. But Seahawks again looking good. Geno Smith looked good. I think they're gonna be a playoff team again this year. I wouldn't be surprised if they win their division. Actually, nah. The 49ers in the division. What am I talking about? But now they're definitely gonna end up either. They're definitely gonna be a close second behind the 49ers. So I wouldn't be surprised about that. Chiefs and Bears. Jesus Christ, Bears. Jesus Christ, y'all got spanked. Y'all got spanked. It wasn't as bad as the Dolphins and Bears, Dolphins and Broncos. But dang, y'all got spanked, bro. Like, I don't even know. It was the fact, no one expected y'all to win. But, I don't know. I don't know what I was expecting. But, yeah. Also, Taylor Swift, Travis Kelce's girlfriend was in attendance for the game. So, that probably gave the Chiefs like plus 10 to their plus a million to their attributes. So like, if you thought you were at even more of a disadvantage, Bears, yeah, Taylor Swift is at the game. So there you go. But Chiefs, Jesus Christ, not bad Chiefs, but Bears, Jesus Christ, do better, y'all. Like, I don't know. I don't know what to say. So, and then we got Cardinals and the Cowboys. I don't want to talk about this. As the person that actually watched the game, as a Cowboys fan and watching the game, I'm disappointed in my Cowboys. I'm disappointed in them. I truly am. This is a team that we should beat, like with the Ravens and the Colts. The Ravens should beat the Colts and they lost. The Cowboys should beat the Cardinals and we lost. The Cardinals. We lost a team that's practically tanking. I'm pissed off. I can't believe it. We couldn't stop Joshua Dobbs. We couldn't stop James Conner, of all people. James Conner. We let up 230 yards, I believe. It was like 220 plus yards of We get 220 yards of rushing yards, 220 rush yards, and it was just a bad game all around. We got to do better. We really got to do better against teams that we should beat, because we should be 3-0. We should be 3-0 right now. We should be, but the fact is we're not, and I'm kind of pissed off about that because we're not. So you got the Steelers and the Raiders. Raiders, what was y'all thinking taking a field goal down by 8? What was the decision there? You know what? I'm gonna cut the lead down to 5. It's still one score. It's still a one score game. You still need a touchdown. What went through your coach's head to make y'all think, oh, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna kick a field goal to narrow it down to 5. Are you that dumb, man? Because if you are, please tell us. I mean, really? I don't know. Steelers, good game. Good job. Y'all gotta win. Eagles versus Bucks. I really thought this was gonna be a lot closer of a game. I really, I honestly thought for a split second that the Buccaneers were actually going to give the Eagles their first loss of the year. I really thought so. I really thought it was a close game at first, and then it just got worse, and I'm just like, yeah, never mind. I was wrong to doubt the Eagles that they were going to lose to the Buccaneers. Baker Mayfield shows your true colors. He threw a pick again. That's the one thing about the Eagles. They're gonna cause fumbles. They're gonna cause turnovers, and that's why they're such a good team, is because they can cause turnovers. They can cause those turnovers, and that was a big thing in this game. They got a pick, and then they got that fumble on not Mike Evans, it's Chris Godwin, and that's why they're gonna be in a lot of games. It's because of their defense. Like, I get it, y'all. They may look like they're gonna lose, and then their defense comes up with a really big tackle or something, and it's just really that easy for them. Then we got the Rams and Bengals. Bengals, good job, y'all got on the board. Rams, I don't know. It was kind of hard to watch both the Eagles and the Rams and Bengals and the Eagles and Buccaneers. So, like, I tried to watch it, but like, why are you having double headers? Why are you having double headers, NFL? You can only watch so many games at one time. Like, I get it, you got NFL Red Zone or whatever, you got those like apps or whatnot to make things easier, but it's like on Monday night, like. Why are you doing it on Monday night though, of all times? It makes no sense to me. So like, I tried to keep up with it, but it was kind of hard to do when there's two games going on at one time. And it's like, I would switch to one and then I switch to the other, and it's just like I just couldn't do it. And so I ended up watching the Eagles more than I did. The Eagles and the Bucks more than I did the Rams and Bengals, and I didn't really miss much because the Bengals really got the win. Jamar Chase finally showed up a bit, so good for y'all. And that was really NFL Week 2. It wasn't the games weren't too good. I guess there were a couple of games, but like majority of games were won by double digits and stuff, and that just made things not so good. Hopefully. Week 4 it can be better. Hopefully this week is a lot better for teams. Hopefully there's a lot of close games, so me and a lot of other football fans can enjoy it. So it's like, hey, you know, we had some good games this week. So yeah, but until next time, I'll see y'all later. Peace.